I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
During his last State of the Nation address, President Rodrigo Duterte says he did not know he was fighting his own government when he first promised to eradicate the country's drug problem within 6 months of his presidency. He explains that he discovered some policemen and customs agents were actually manufacturers and distributors of illegal drugs.
Look for the enemies. Look where they are. And if you find them, destroy the apparatus. Destroy all, from the manufacturers to the peddlers. Because we are fighting a drug war.
Duterte maintains high approval and trust scores. According to Publicis Asia, 58% of Filipino respondents approve his performance, while 55% continue to trust him. He claims the Philippines has ramped up its COVID-19 response, particularly when it comes to testing. But he asks for patience when it comes to getting more vaccines to the country. Dozens of protesters gathered at the Philippine Consulate General in New York City on Sunday in what they call the People's Sona, describing the Duterte regime as a complete disaster.
He did not actually address some of the root problems answer to the concerns of the Filipino people that he had promised during his election campaign. Yung guerra contra droga, ang daming namatay doon, yung illegal drugs, it's still there.
In Vancouver, Canada, Filipino activists also held a protest in time for Duterte's Sona, calling for an end to his regime as he is seriously considering to run for vice president in next year's elections.
I count on all Filipinos in the diaspora as well as in the Philippines to change this government.
And finally, in sports news, Heidelin Diaz has become the Philippines' first ever Olympic gold medalist Monday, winning the women's 55-kilogram for weightlifting at Tokyo 2020. The 30-year-old Diaz lifted a combined weight of 224 kilograms, an Olympic record. Meanwhile, on Sunday, Phil-Am fencer Lee Kiefer bagged her first ever Olympic gold medal in the individual women's foil fencing event, beating defending Ina Diriglavosa in the final. Kiefer maintained her lead throughout the match against Diriglavosa, who was ranked number one in the world.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News, and on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Kapamilya.
I'm TJ Manotok, and this is your TFC News Now.
Let's begin with the tragic news out of British Columbia and Canada, where a Filipino father lost his life to save his sons. 53-year-old Anouf Salazar drowned after saving his son from the strong currents of Lake Chelles while they were on a family trip.
In a split second, like, Zach started drifting away. So that's when I started calling for help because it was just too far for me to get him.
Anouf immediately waded through the waters to get his 10-year-old son, Zach, who has autism. Bystanders who heard the cries helped Anouf and reached out to grab the child after Anouf pushed his son towards them. But after getting his son to safety, the strong current pulled Anouf down the lake.
It's still like a big shock to us because it did happen just so fast. And like, we never expected such things to happen on that day.
Moving on to sports news, Filipino-Canadian swimmer Kayla Sanchez fulfilled her promise to give it her best at her Olympic debut by helping give Canada its memorable first medal at the Tokyo Olympic Games. Sanchez was the lead-off swimmer in Team Canada's silver medal finish in the women's 4x100m freestyle relay over the weekend. She clocked in personal bests 53.45 in the prelims and 53.42 in the final. Despite the pressure that came with swimming leadoff, the Scarborough native says she chose to step up and do what she needed to do for her team. And finally, Pinoy pride at the T-Mobile Baseball Park in Seattle as the Mariners hosted Filipino Heritage Night recently. The stadium was filled as Washingtonians cheered on their home team, which defeated Oakland A's with a score of 4-3.
This is my first time and this is awesome.
It was also a proud moment for many Pinoy fans as they received limited edition shirts and watched performances that celebrate Filipino culture.
I feel proud that Filipinos are being recognized and honored, and it's nice to partner with Seattle Mariners for Filipino Heritage Night.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube page. Stay with us, Kapamilya.
I'm Ramel Kinclara, and this is your TSC News Now. Let's begin with COVID-19 news in the U.S. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention now recommends that Americans fully vaccinated should go back to wearing masks in indoor public places in regions where infections are spreading rapidly. The CDC also urges all students, teachers, and school staff from kindergarten to 12th grade to wear facial coverings while on campus, regardless of their vaccination status. COVID-19 cases have been on the rise in all 50 states due to the highly contagious Delta variant, which now accounts for more than 80% of all cases in the country.
The science shows now that even people who are vaccinated and get a breakthrough infection can transmit. So the solution to all of this is to get vaccinated and get that 100 million people in the country who are eligible for vaccines who have not gotten vaccinated to get vaccinated.
According to the CDC, only 49.2% of the U.S. population is fully vaccinated. Moving on to sports, the NBA draft is all set for Thursday night in Brooklyn, and the question of which team will take Phil-Am Hoops sensation Jalen Green will finally be answered. The 19-year-old from Fresno, California, addressed the media on Tuesday afternoon. Green, one of the first players to go through the G League's Professional Pathway program, says he has no regrets and is excited to hear his name called on draft night. He's expected to land in the top 5, possibly as high as a number 2 pick, which would send him to the Houston Rockets. The 19-year-old traces his Philippine roots through his mother, Bri Buruganan, whose father is from a local Sur. Green shows his love for the Philippines, which he's visited on several occasions.
I love the Philippines. They show love and support. I'm just happy I get to represent them.
And finally, Manny Pacquiao continues to push himself to the limit to get himself ready for his August 21st fight against Errol Spence. After a quick 7-round sparring session on Tuesday, the Pac-Man got to take a break when he got a special visit and a jersey from NBA All-Star Karl Anthony Towns of the Minnesota Timberwolves.
This is awesome. He's a legend, so it means a lot to be here. It means a lot to be in one of his camps. You know, you never know how long he got, but he feels like he's immortal. His time does affect him, so Father Time may have to lose one again.
The two-time NBA All-Star not only posed with the Pac-Man's team and family, but also had fun holding the Filipino boxer's WBA Super Bantamweight belt. And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TSC news on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TSC News, and on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Kapamilya. I'm Ramel Kinclara, and this is your TSC News Now. The U.S. Federal Reserve assures Americans that the country's economic recovery remains on track. The Fed Chair Jerome Powell admits there's still some ground to cover on the labor market side.
We're clearly on a path to a very strong labor market with high participation, low unemployment, high employment, wages moving up across the spectrum.
In its advanced estimate of the second quarter gross domestic product, the U.S. Commerce Department says it rose to a 6.5% annualized rate. The economy grew at a revised 6.3% rate in the first quarter. Still, experts say the economic outlook could be threatened by a resurgence in COVID-19 infections driven by the Delta variant. When social distancing and COVID safety protocols reduced the number of available slots for consular services at the Philippine Consulate General in New York, it led to a backlog in services.
Hindi po ba pwede na magkaroon ng mas maraming manpower upang magkaroon ng mas malawakang o madaling schedule ang ating mga kababayan para makakuha ng pasaporte at magkaroon din, makakuha din sila ng proseso sa pagkakaroon ng dual citizenship.
For the past year, we really, really were affected so hard in terms of us being forced to limit the number of kababayans we could serve.
Conchon Cato says since then they've made improvements. In fact, beginning April this year, the number of consular services increased by nearly 50% after adding 200 additional passport appointment slots per month, plus opening consulate doors on certain Saturdays. And finally, in Virginia Beach, Virginia, at the global headquarters of Operation Smile, where the Anthony L. Hideko S. Burgess Interactive Learning Center was recently built, members of the Filipino community were recognized for their contributions to the organization.
You're very, very special people. And without you, Operation Smile would not be where it is today with 6,000 volunteers.
The center allows visitors to learn more about the patients and families that Operation Smile serves in over 80 countries, especially the Philippines, where it all began.
Operation Smile, by God's grace, they rescued me.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC news on the ABS-CBN news website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC news, and on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Cup of Million.
I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
Let's begin with a pivotal new discovery shared by the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention when it comes to the Delta variant of COVID-19. According to the CDC, it produces the same amounts of virus in vaccinated and unvaccinated people if they get infected. This means that the risk of transmission is similar regardless of your vaccination status. The CDC says this is a main reason why they are recommending that fully vaccinated Americans wear masks indoors.
It is clear that they are capable of transmitting the infection to uninfected individuals.
Fauci hopes U.S. regulators could, as soon as the middle of next month, start granting full approval for the use of COVID-19 vaccines, which are already authorized on an emergency basis. A formal approval by the Food and Drug Administration would give doctors the ability to prescribe a third dose of the vaccine to people with weakened immune systems on an off-label basis.
The Houston Rockets select Jalen Green.
Moving on to sports, the future is bright for the Houston Rockets' number 2 NBA draft pick, Phil-Am Jalen Green, who played for the G League Ignite. Green says he's excited to represent Texas's large Filipino community.
I'm excited to take that out there and just represent, put on for the Philippines, and can't wait to meet everybody and see the fans.
Green will join reigning sixth man of the year, Jordan Clarkson, as the only active Filipino-American players in the league. Phil-Am fans are excited for this development, especially young hoopsters like Jacob Colocado.
Welcome to H-Town, Jalen Green. It's just an inspiration because we see all these Filipino people making it to the league right now, and it's making us Filipinos, you know, with more pride. Him, Jordan Clarkson, just watching him in prolific prep, and now he's with the Houston Rockets.
And finally, in entertainment news, for the first time ever, the Primetime Emmy Awards will honor outstanding stunt performers in television shows. One of the nominees is Phil-Am Mark Canonizado, recognized for his work as the stunt double of original Karate Kid Ralph Macchio and his Cobra Kai co-star Sholo Maridueña.
It was really cool to see that our hard work, even on that show, gets to really be seen and be put out there.
The Primetime Emmys will be held on September 19th.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC news on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube page. Stay with us, Kapamilya.